What does OVO even stand for? Other vaginal option? I don't feel like doing that today. Y'all, they beefing. They beefing bad. They are beefing bad. The girls are growling. Running up a sack like a quarterback. Ain't making no sense, so you can't get your quarterback. 5'5", 10, fresh face, the new tracks. Sitting around the world, run around in the hill. I'm literally recording this at 9:14 at night. I was supposed to be taking my makeup off and ripping this wig off and going to bed, but as I was about to get in the car to come home, Mrs. Kendrick Lamam decided to drop another diss again. This is what, 4 disses now? And it maybe 5? This at least 3 in the last 24 hours. You missed my live earlier this week with my bestie Kayla. Me and Kayla have a podcast where we reference and we talk about different hot topics, and we actually reference the beat between Drake and the beef between Drake and Kendrick in our live, which is our podcast, which, by the way, please help us name our podcast. Whoever comes up with the best name in the comment section below, I will be sending you a $100 gift card to Amazon. Anyway, So we did reference that in our live, so definitely check that out, and I'll link it in the description box below. Anyway, Kendrick Lamam, it's just so much going on, and I don't know if I need to start from the beginning, so I'm gonna just give you a brief overview. Actually, fuck all that. I don't feel like doing a brief overview. If you watch the live, then you know what's going on and why Kendrick Lamam and Drizziana are arguing, why the girls is tussling and windmilling each other. I don't feel like doing that today. Maybe if this happened, you know, when I was well rested and I wasn't ready to rip these fucking lashes off, maybe I would have did that. But Kendrick said, fuck all that. And you know how diabolical he is? He put out a club record at 9 at night. Why would he do that? Because he knows the strippers are just now putting their draws on to go let it go, to go make it ripple, okay? To go get his, they're just now leaving, you know, the dressing room. Everybody get out the dressing room. They're just now leaving the dressing room. If you know where that's from, I love you. But they're just now leaving the dressing room. So they're really about to start getting active in like maybe an hour or so. So Kendrick put out a club record. So that way the club, the DJs, because the DJs, if they're doing their job, they're going to play this in the club. And you know what goes off in the club? Music with a sickening beat. I guess Party is playing with powder now, allegedly. He's just bringing all these things to light about his team. And then he shifts the focus over to Drake and said, what does OVO even stand for? Other vaginal option? You know, fun fact, the lore of, you know, Arikari, this used to be a music reaction channel. Fun fact, a lot of y'all don't know that, but this was a music reaction channel at one point. I stopped doing it because the record labels, one, they will pull your video down, two, you can get sued, and three, being a woman in the music space, especially when it comes to music that is male dominated, you just tend to have a lot of men in your comments and men watching your stuff, and men tend to be really harmful and hurtful to women when they have critiques that they don't agree with. Even when women have critiques that they do agree with, they tend to discredit women and be like, oh, what do you know about music? You have a vagina. There's no possible way you could be a historian of music. You have boobs. Like, that's basically, it's very objectifying, very disrespectful. So I just didn't continue to do it, but I was pretty successful as well. Fun fact, the lore of this channel.
I see dead people.
He starts it off saying he sees dead people, referencing all the people he has since buried, since put in the grave, especially with this song. Has Mustard worked with Drake before? Because that's something that I always wondered, considering Drake is going against someone who's from the West Coast, and I feel like he's worked with West Coast artists many times. So I would think he would want to use a West Coast artist to diss Kendrick if that's what he's trying to do. But he didn't. So I'm like, does he not work with them over there? John Stockton is crazy. Woo!
Hey Drake, I hear you like I'm young. You better not ever go to sell Black One.
I hear you like them young. Again, he's just putting, he's, again, in his previous disses, I feel like he was more so alluding to Drake being around predators. He's just straight up calling Drake what it is now. I hear you like them young. You better not go to cell block one. Meaning, you know what happens to child predators when they go to jail. So you better hope you never see a jail cell.
To any bitch that talk to him and they in love, just make sure you hide your little sister from him.
Make sure you hide your little sister. It's bad. It's really bad. Woo! It's getting crazy! It's getting crazy! Oh my god!
They tell me Chubb's the only one that gets your hand-me-downs. And probably at the party playing with his nose now. And Baka got a weird case, why is he around? Certified lover boys, certified pedophiles. Wow.
He's calling it what it is. He's literally certified. He's calling it what it is. I didn't like the party line because I am a Party Next Door fan. And you know what? If he is doing powder, damn it, the album was good. So, I don't even care if he is doing powzers. If he is doing a little, you know, a little Pepsi. It's his business if he likes Dr. Pepper. What does that have to do with the Mew Mew? Let's just here, keep it going.
Just make sure you hide your little sister from him. They tell me Chubb's the only one that gets your hand-me-downs. And probably at the party playing with his nose now. And Baka got a weird case, why is he around? Certified lover boys, certified pedophiles. Wah, 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 wah. Dad, fuck him up. Wah, 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 wah. I'ma do my stuff. Why you trying to...
See, okay, going back to what I said earlier, Kendrick is so diabolical. He is so diabolical because he knew I'm gonna drop this early enough that the clubs in Atlanta can play it tonight. Tonight. One thing about Kendrick, he is not, he thinks these things through. So I know someone, whether it was him or whether it was someone in his camp, was like, don't drop until 9-ish Eastern time. Don't do 12, because he easily could have did midnight. Don't do 12 because we want it to be early enough that the clubs can play it, but late enough that the clubs can play it. Oh, he's smart. That diabolical man. And as someone who lives in Atlanta, even though he was dissing, you know, not dissing, but kind of dragging people from the city that we're in right now, as someone who lives in Atlanta, if I heard this in the club,
like a bitch, ain't you tired? Trying to strike a chord and it's probably A minor.
Trying to strike a chord and it's probably A minor. Here's the thing. One thing I do want to say as well, Kendrick Lamar is a Pulitzer Prize winner for words. So I do hope you guys know that he is dumbing this down so that way regular people can hear it without having to do the Googles or do the research to understand what he's saying, because he could be a lot more, I don't want to say obtuse, but he could be a lot more like, abstract about what he is saying, but he's saying it very clear. He's a pedo. You know, he strikes a chord, it's probably A minor. Like, he's big, party's doing powder. Like, he's being very literal, so that way you guys can't miss what he's saying because he's being too, you know, abstract and he's using too big of words. No, he's saying it as is. Very to the point. Also, he's making fun of him because Drake did free editing me here. So something I didn't notice when I reacted to this last night as I'm editing it is when he did probably A minor, I thought he was just dissing Drake with the whole Drake using the free in his diss to Kendrick from the day prior. And also alluding to him being, you know, a child predator. But what I didn't catch is that who is most known for E and dragging out their words? Nicolas Minaj. And whose husband also cannot be around a minor.
So I feel like it was a triple diss. I think it was, of course, a diss to Drake. I think obviously A minor, he sings in A minor as well as he can't be around children. But I also think it's Nicki Minaj-ery as well. I hope Megan Thee Stallion is somewhere with like a pina colada in her hand, you know, topless on a beach or on a yacht, living her best life. And I hope she plays the song on the beach or yacht with a drink just in her hand, natural hair just flourishing. What a time to be a Megan fan.
In his diss record, which Drake got that from Nicki, because Nicki draws out her... Anytime Nicki is on a song, it's either going to be "these bitches are my sons" or she's going to draw out a word, or it's one of those three. It's one of the three, you know, eeny, meeny, miny, moe, tic-tac-toe, if you will. But she's going to do one of them. So Drake got that from Nicki, and then to mock him, he now did it in his diss song back to Drake.
They not like us. 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 You think that they gon' let you disrespect Pop, nigga? I think that open show will be your last stop, nigga. It cold foul, I don't know why you still pretending. What is the owl? Bird niggas and bird bitches go. The honey is not dumb, she niggas are getting wedgie. You flipped over your boxes, or over your phone. The other vaginal option.
The other vaginal option. You know, there's just a, I don't know what type of word to call someone who is this diabolical, sinister. You know what I mean? Like, you know, and at this point we must acquiesce, you know, we must acquiesce to the truth that Kendrick has won this. Kendrick won this after Euphoria, in my opinion. There is no response Drake could give that was going to outdo Euphoria. Granted, I do think Drake's response, I hope Kendrick addresses the "you beat your wife" allegations, even though he was like, "you got a mixed queen." But Kendrick's wife, her mother is biracial and then her father is black. So she is 3/4 black. She's a black lady. You know what I'm saying? Like, she's a black lady. She's just light skinned. So that was kind of, but again, to me, after Euphoria, there was no response Drake could give that was going to beat it. There was no response Drake was going to give that was going to beat it. Kendrick has now diss-record him from morning to night. From morning to night. This man, Drake dropped yesterday at like, I'm going to argue, 9:45. Kendrick dropped by 10:15. 30-minute interlude. A 30-minute break, if you will. We had a lunch break. Right back to business. Then Kendrick said, oh, wait, I'm going to drop again and I'm going to do it late at night so that the clubs can shake their fucking ass. Because not only are you going to hear me in your car, you're going to hear me on the internet, but you're going to hear me in the fucking club. And that's Drake's whole MO. Like, this man is so surgical with the way that he does his disses because he knows I am going to give you a club record, because that's the one thing y'all keep saying is that Drake is going to beat me because he has the records that make the bitches shake ass. Bend that ass over. Let that coochie breathe. Shake that ass for Drake. Shake that ass for me. He literally referenced it in his diss. And look at what Kendrick gave you. And he went to DJ Mustard, who is known for making ass-shaking records specifically for YG. I really kind of wish he would have had YG on this, but I also understand that this is a solo assignment and not a group project.
Fucked on Wayne's girl while he was in jail. That's conniving. Then get his face tatted like a...
Fucked on Wayne's girl while he was in jail. That's conniving. I need to know, who is that? What happened there? Can someone tell? I don't know the tea.
Bitch apologizing, I'm glad D Rose came home. Y'all didn't deserve him either. From a launcher down to central, nigga, been asked me go some reason. Just like another line of walk, yeah, all eyes on me, and I'ma send it up the park. I put the road label on me, I'ma get them dropped. I preaching music, and I won't pass the ox. I how many.
Come on, all eyes on me. And I'll send it up to Pac, because Drake tried to use Tupac's AI voice, which was so horrible. I just really hate that people are doing the AI post-mortem voices of people in general, but especially not in a diss. You had to know the Tupac's family was gonna hear that and want you to take it down. And like, a lot of y'all, quick rant and then we're gonna continue. A lot of y'all be resurrecting the dead in these in these disses, and I really hate that. Cause it's like, that's someone's family that you're now resurrecting unprovoked for your own personal gain. Don't ever do no dumb shit like that again.
Do I really have a stock? Aye, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 plus 5. Aye, devil is a lie. Here's 69. God, aye, freaky ass niggas need to stay their ass inside.
Freaky ass niggas. Which, that, I think, came from Twitter. I mean, Kendrick probably won't say it, but he definitely got that from Twitter. Because there was a man that went viral on Twitter, and he was like, you freaky ass nigga. You's a freaky fraud. Freaky fraud, you freaky ass nigga. You know, and Drake might be a freaky fraud. He might be a freaky fraud. We don't know. I'm glad Kendrick addressed that, because the fact that Drake was like, oh, you still rapping like you trying to free the slaves? What's wrong with freeing the slaves, Drake? I think you just proved his point, actually. I really think you just proved his point. And, you know, this is why he said you can't say nigga no more. The fact that you're like, oh, you rapping like you're trying to free the slaves as an insult?
What's the mecca building railroads and trains? Bear with me for a second. Let me put y'all on game. The settlers will choose a town folk to make them richer. Fast forward 2024. You got the same agenda.
Yeah, he's calling him, you're a modern day slave owner. You're a modern day colonist.
To Atlanta when you need a check balance. Let me break it down for you. This the real nigga challenge. You call future when you didn't see the club.
Now he's referencing the Atlanta rappers that Drake has used to feel cool, to get notoriety, to be, you know, in the limelight with them. Future, Lil Baby, 21, can you do something for me? Literally doing something for me. Yeah, as someone who lives in Atlanta, like I said, that man is diabolical. He put it out because the hoes are just now getting their outfit together to go to the club in about 20 minutes. And you know what the DJs is gonna play. You know what they're going to play.
Yo, baby, help you get your he a fan.
He said, freaky ass nigga, you're a fan.
Step this way.
Yep, he ate no crumbs. That's it.